It's a rainy one out there. Good morning, everybody. I'm Sean McDonald. Thanks for joining us here on News 9 Plus on YouTube, Facebook, and X. And you're going to want to keep that umbrella close today. Here's why: it's an impact weather day due to the steady rain that's expected to last throughout the day today. A live look there at 93. It could lead to some ponding out on the roadways, and minor river and stream flooding is also a possibility. Let's check in with Kevin right now. It's ugly out there.
It is not great, to say the least. Western and northern areas will see a little bit less today, and you're probably down to just some mist or drizzle at times. While closer to the coastline, it is a steady rain and the potential of over an inch and a half of rain. Because of that, a flood watch is posted for the southeastern half of the state as the front slowly, and I mean very slowly, from tonight and into tomorrow, makes its way offshore. There's a weak area of low pressure developing along this line of rain, so you can see south of New England another batch of rain, which will be heading northward through the day. Temps will be in the 40s out there this afternoon. Again, a lighter version of this rain for western and northern areas of the state, and a light wind, so not necessarily a cool, raw day with temperatures in the 30s and rainfall. It'll be in the 40s. But again, that rain will be persistent through the afternoon and into this evening. A back edge making its way across the state tomorrow morning. That will set up even a few breaks of sunshine tomorrow afternoon. Some sunshine to start the weekend with highs in the 40s. And there'll be a weak system gliding out of Canada Sunday afternoon, and it could kick off a rain or a snow shower. But that's it for the weekend through Monday, actually, as the next system wanders in Tuesday and Wednesday of next week. We are likely going to finish either fourth or third wettest March, with this being the last system, giving us almost three times our normal rainfall for the month of March.
It seems to be a lot of rain. We did have snow on that one Saturday, though.
We did, but that, yeah, that's all and melted down and part of the equation. But yes, this has been quite the unsettled pattern after a top 10 driest February.
Interesting. All right, Kevin, thanks. People in the Lakes region are still reeling this morning after an earthquake rattled the area. The quake struck just before 9 last night in Laconia. According to the USGS, the 2.2 magnitude tremor was centered along White Oaks Road just west of Laconia Airport. There are no reports of any damage, but a lot of folks feeling that. Further north, many people are reported hearing a loud boom, but it's not clear exactly what the sound was. We started getting emails around 4 yesterday afternoon from people who said they could feel buildings shaking in the Conway area. The USGS tells us they did not see an earthquake around that time in the Conway area. We also reached out to the FAA, who referred us to the military, so a bit of a mystery there. Now to a shakeup in New Hampshire politics. Representative Annie Custer says she will not seek re-election after this term. That second district spot is now wide open for the November election. The Congresswoman tells News 9 she's making time with her family a priority, but will continue trying to help elect more of her fellow Democrats. Custer has represented CD2 since 2013. Former Senator and Democratic vice presidential nominee Joe Lieberman has died. He passed away yesterday from complications from a fall. Lieberman ran for vice president on a ticket with Al Gore in 2000. He also ran for president in 2004, at one point even renting an apartment in Manchester to live in the first in the nation state.
One of the most decent and honest, the kind of person you really enjoyed being with. And that was really how I made my decision in 2004 was, what's the person I want to spend the next year hanging out with? And it was an easy decision. It was Joe Lieberman.
Lieberman was a large part of the No Labels movement, which is remembering him in a statement as a, quote, man of uncommon integrity who did things for the right reasons. Joe Lieberman was 82 years old. Guilford police are on the lookout for a man they say assaulted a Wendy's worker and flashed a gun. The manager of the Wendy's on Lakeshore Road told us the suspect was upset because he didn't want to wait for his order. Noah White says it was around 8:30 yesterday morning when the suspect pulled up through the drive-thru window, reached in and smacked him in the face. White says he went outside to take a picture of the suspect's license plate, but the man allegedly tackled him and punched him. Before going outside, White says the man threatened to shoot him.
Like, pulled it out, and like, he didn't pull the gun out of the case, but it was just like more of just like he was trying to intimidate me. Some people are just ignorant and crazy, I guess.
And the suspect drove off after the assault, and White was not able to get the license plate number. Police say they do have evidence and they believe will help identify that suspect. The last two remaining coal-fired power plants in New England will both close in the next few years. Schiller in Portsmouth will close next year. Merrimack in Bow will remain operational until 2028. The facilities will be transformed into hubs for renewable energy. It is opening day for the Red Sox. Boston is starting the season with a late game tonight at the Seattle Mariners. It's been a quiet offseason, so you may not recognize some of the names in the starting lineup. The first five batters are all starters returning from last year, including Rafael Devers and Trevor Story. Tyler O'Neill is their new outfielder. He's played six seasons in St. Louis. Rounding out the batting order is a couple of younger players there as well. But baseball getting underway tonight. A deer is safe and back in the woods after being rescued by police in Canaan. They say the deer got trapped in an iron cemetery fence on Tuesday. The animal was stuck between the fence pickets. This video shows the moments an officer was able to lift the deer's leg so it could safely get out right there. Police say the deer appeared to be okay, except for a loss of a little bit of hair, but back in the woods. Thanks for joining us here on News 9 Plus on Facebook, X, and YouTube. Have that umbrella handy today in the rain. Have a great day, everybody.